Hello, everyone. This is my report to the congregation for 2020. So this will be shared with you before our annual meeting as well as during our annual meeting. At the end of 2019, our theme was to be a light for other people, that we would live so that others will see our good works and glorify our Father in heaven. We didn't know at the end of 2019 that our theme would really come true for us in a lot of ways, that in 2020 we would have way more opportunities to share our light than we imagined. We also, at the end of 2019, we would not have imagined that we could share our light with more people when we can't gather in person. We didn't imagine that we would have to stay away from our church building for now it's been 10 months. And that even when we're far away from each other physically, somehow we would stay connected. And at the end of 2019, I'm certain that we would not have imagined that we could continue to worship together from a distance. And that really and truly, when we're far apart from one another, as we have been in 2020, that we would expand the number of people involved in our congregation. So for those of us who have been part of Bread of Life, going to our church building and being together in person, we certainly feel deep loss here at the start of 2021. But surprisingly, 2020 was a good year for our church. It was not an easy year, but Bold Church adapted to the many, many challenges that we faced in 2020. And I know for myself, my faith has taken on new meaning, the sense that God is with us is more real and more alive for me today than it was a year ago. So I wrote a whole bunch of bullet points, 5 pages of stuff that you can look at to see what have we been doing? Because even though we are not going to our church building, our church is still working. God is still calling us and helping us be active in the world. So if you are like, I really miss being at Bread of Life and you're not very involved right now, you can get involved. There's lots that can be done, even though everything is quite different now. So our council continued to meet in 2020. We figured out how to meet online and how to make sure that we're communicating with one another. And we continue to adjust how we do our meetings. And we'll figure out ways to allow people, if anybody is needing or wanting to watch our council meetings, we can figure out how to include an audience to watch us too. Our secretary, Barb Schmidt, prepared a video sharing all of the different council actions and motions for 2020. So you'll be able to see how many things the council has been doing during 2020. Our finance committee has also been very busy. They've done a lot of work. We hired a different bookkeeper in April, and we shifted a bunch of our work to allow our bookkeeper to work from home and work online. We figured out how to set up PayPal, and we engaged some new givers with that. We were able to secure a loan from the federal government, a Paycheck Protection Program loan, and that recently was forgiven as well. So our staff were able to continue to be paid, and no one was laid off. Our annual fundraiser changed forms, and we shifted to the online website Give to the Max Day. And we raised more money in 2020 than we did in 2019 with that annual fundraiser. Another group that's been very faithful and busy are our counters. They go into Bread of Life every week, or every other week, I think, every other week, and count and make sure our deposits are taken care of. Our building committee has continued to do projects, taking care of like normal things, shoveling and lawn care, but also doing some special things. They replaced 3 of our toilets. They waxed the floors. They continue to check in on the building and make sure that it's safe and secure. And our building committee folks have continued to research future projects to help take care of our church building. We also have a group of folks who've been committed to making sure they're checking in with our members who are homebound, people who even without COVID couldn't go out. They just can't get out. It's too challenging. And they've been able to figure out how to do those visits and connect with people while keeping everyone safe. The other thing I just need to say quickly is our staff has really had to adjust, and been very grateful that our staff at Bread of Life are willing to adjust how they work and try new approaches to the things that we're doing. This includes our regular interpreters as well. They've really helped us be effective and continue to provide high quality worship for a much wider audience now than we were a year ago. I want to mention that Bread of Life continues our partnership with Bethel Evangelical Lutheran Church. Lent 2020, so about a year ago, we were just entering into Lent. And last year we were so excited because we had a shared meal. The first week we planned for 30 people and more than 40 people came. And then the next week we planned for more people and that same thing happened. We set up for 60 and I think 70 people showed up. And then we had to stop meeting in person because of COVID. So we've continued to work with Bethel, trying to figure out how do we build partnership even in this time when everything is quite different. And so now during Epiphany, we are sharing preachers. And so you'll see Pastor Brenda, you will see Dr. Jen, and they will see, Bethel will see me and Deacon Dorothy and intern Lori. So we are trying hard to continue our goals of building partnerships and expanding and reaching out to others. One thing I want to mention that was very fun and surprising how well it worked was that this summer we had a day camp. And in June, we had a week-long camp. Every morning we would meet for a couple hours with a group of about 50 kids from our Will congregation and 10 other congregations in South Minneapolis. And then we kept meeting once a week through the rest of the summer. And that event we had interpreted every week, and all of the Bible stories for the kids, the water stories and information, it was all interpreted for the kids and for us. And those videos are still available for people to take advantage of and watch. We restarted our newsletter in 2020 to try to re-engage members who don't have internet and don't have a way to watch worship or get information online. But we also have started some online classes in Zoom. So every week we have Bible study. We have a current events discussion group, and every Sunday morning, there are people who gather for a coffee hour and conversation. So I know 2020 was not what we imagined it would be. And God is still calling us, and the church is still working. Which makes me wonder, as we, as Bold Church enters its 65th year, what surprises will God bring to us in 2021? And I wonder how we will respond. I wonder what brave and bold new things we might try in 2021. So peace be with you all.